trying to get a good variety, not just pick all 12 Cassie Clare books, because it could have easily have done that as well. So, let's get started. Okay, starting off strong with The Clockwork Princess by Cassandra Clare. This is book 3 in the Infernal Devices series, which is the prologue series before the Mortal Instruments series, which was the original 6. Oh my god, a broken spine. Did I do that? Oh my god. I didn't think I'd ever broken a spine. Well, I guess I lied in my reading habits. So we're going to find a very common saying in this video is going to be, I don't really remember what happened, but I know I loved it. So I apologize now for any times I might be saying that. Oh my god, I'm just ruining this book. Okay, stop touching. Okay, so this is book 3 in the Infernal Devices. There's the Clockwork Prince, the Clockwork Angel, and then this one. This one was my favorite because I just loved how the romance ended up. So this book has a love triangle between Tessa, Will, and Jem. And in this book, she's engaged to Jem. But Jem has to make a life decision to save himself because of his sickness. And I am quite happy about that. Obviously, I'm happy that Jem saved his life. I am a Tessa Will stan. Instead of a Tessa Jem stan. So, sorry about that. But, I loved this book. This book made me, so I originally read these 6 when I was in grade 7 to 8. So that would have been 2011 to 2012 that I read these books. And then I didn't read this one until, like, 2018 because I kind of stopped reading in high school, so grades 9 and 10 and 11, I didn't read a whole lot. And then I found out that these existed, so I picked them up immediately and I binged them. I do not reread books. I just have never really been interested in it. But while I was going through and trying to find all my favorite books, I was like, man, I really want to reread these books. So there are some firsts for everything. This one is not a 5 out of 5. I give this one a 4 out of 5. This book is about, it's made Greek mythology. It is Circe by Madeline Miller, who is also the author of A Song of Achilles, which I have not read. But this book is about a Greek goddess named Circe, who gets banished from her home and has to live life in solitary. Possesses power, which like can transform rivals into monsters and menace the gods themselves. And she's like her mother, and her father hated that, unfortunately. And she was never considered the pretty daughter. He had a bunch of daughters, but she was his least favorite, and that was kind of known. And then she breaks a law by helping another god who has been sentenced to this moves from academic to experimental, things go horribly wrong. This book is so good in finding the love for reading super villains. You like, you're cheering for the super villains rather than the superheroes. Recommend buying them on Poshmark or thrifting them. These were both, I think, $38.99 before tax in Canadian dollars. So, oh no, sorry, this one's $33.99, so $25.99 US, $33.99 Canadian. This one was $36.50 Canadian, $27.99 American. I'm not sure which one I liked better. I think I liked the first book better, but I know a lot of people like the second one better due to the new character that gets introduced. Ah, Catching Fire. Everybody knows this book. This is the second book in the Hunger Games trilogy by Suzanne Collins. I read these in grade 7, so 2011 or 2010. And I, you know, devoured them just like everybody else did. School got to go to the movie theater during school to watch this before it opening day in the theaters. So say it came, I'm pretty sure it was the day before, so like say it came out on the Friday, we got to go Thursday at like 11 a.m. and our whole grade 8 and maybe, or no, grade 7 and then grade 8 as well. Maybe I was in grade 8. Yeah, I think I was in grade 8. We all got to go and watch the movie together, the first one when it came out. The reason I liked this book over the other two the best was I loved the second arena and all the new characters we got introduced to in this one, like all the new victors and just the thrill of it. If I put them in order, this one and the original Hunger Games, the first book, would be very close tied. Like, I like them for different reasons. And then Mockingbird, or Mockingjay. Mockingjay is always in place, unfortunately. I am a pita forever. I don't know. I can't it's like a thriller fantasy. Like, it's been a both. It could have been either categories. Alright, 5 out of 5. Fully recommend. Which book was it? 4 out of 5. I missed one, didn't I? Is there a season 4 out of 5? And then... oh, I guess there's just one 4 out of 5 in all of these. Harry Potter. Whoa. So this is Harry Potter, Prisoner of Azkaban, which is the third book in the 7-book series. I have a video on my channel a few videos back of me ranking the Harry Potter books and which ones I like the most and the least and whatnot. This one is close to the top. The next one's Harry Potter as well. The reason I like this book, I really like the martyrs, as well as how everything makes a complete circle. Oh shit, you can see that. There's a lot of like loose ends going into the last, say, 50 pages of this book, and you're like, why is that happening? Why didn't we figure out what happened to the end of that? But everything gets answered. All of your questions get answered. You're like, oh my god, how did she do that? How did J.K. Rowling make everything just come together and actually make sense in the end? So that's why this is one of my favorite books. There's a thing going around right now where everybody's in love with Sirius Black. And, you know, they're like, they want to date him. Honestly, I don't see that. If you've read the book, you know how annoying Sirius Black is. Not this book, but in the future ones, like in books 4. A whiny little baby. He's like, Harry, I miss you. I'm alone. Please come hang out with me. Even though Harry's like at school. And if Harry's like, no, I can't, he gets so moody. He's like, fine, but your father would have done it for me. Why won't you? Kind of thing. Like, he's a big, big baby. I actually don't like him as much as everybody else. I feel like everybody who says that just thinks the actor's hot, but not basing it off of the actual book. We have this big book, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. So, this book is really good. I love the Triwizard Tournament. The way it's perceived in the movie is not as good. They leave out a lot of information. They leave out a whole lot of Dobby stuff. How good Dobby is. And I really don't like that. It's a big book. You get a lot of good information in it, and it's very world building. Like, you get a lot of like big spell battles and fighting and all that. And this is before Harry becomes a little sensitive because of Cedric's death, so that's good. Yeah, Ghosts of the Shadow. Market. This is a, like, almost short story collection of sideline things that happened within the series of the Mortal Instruments, the Infernal Devices, and the Dark Art Devices series. And you get just some, like, more information on side characters, main characters, some other things that they're doing other than just fighting these big wars. The main characters in this are definitely Magnus and Jem. is my favorite genre, so it's really nice going back.